The RX 6750 XT is a GPU that wasn't really well received when it came out last year. Has the recent price decrease changed anything? In this video, we'll showcase the power of this graphics card against other GPUs in 10 popular games of 1080p and 1440p to see how it stacks up in 2023. We'll also see how it performs in productivity benchmarks and ray tracing. So sit tight and join us for a deep dive into the RX 6750 XT and discover why it's one of the top picks. Let's dive right into the specs of this card. While the 3080 and 3060 Ti may have an edge in some areas, the 6750 XT strikes back with a much higher base and boost clock, a whopping 52% higher than even the 3080. But that's not all. It also beats the 3060 Ti in effective memory speed and memory size, with an additional 4GB of GDDR6 and even 2GB more than the 3080. That's especially important considering how memory hogging games can be nowadays. However, there is a catch. Despite having fewer cores and ROPs, the 6750 XT still costs $55 more than the 3060 Ti. So is it worth it? We'll find out as we put this card to test at 1080p and 1440p, both rasterization and ray tracing and max settings. Will its clock speeds prove to be a fierce contender against even the mighty 3080? Let's find out. Now, if you're buying this card, you're probably not targeting 1080p most of the time, but we've included it here so you can get more of a complete picture on how it performs at different resolutions. And if you're into 1080p gaming, this card will do the job just fine. As a 1440p targeted card, it handily outperforms the 3060 Ti and most games that favor more from the GPU. This suggests that AMD's driver improvements are having a noticeable impact. But let's take a closer look at the average FPS for 1080p. Interestingly, it doesn't actually outperform the 3060 Ti on average. It lost by 2%, which could be the margin of error, or it could be that its losses in games like CSGO and Rainbow Six and GTA 5 outweighed its gains in newer titles. It also loses to the 3080 by 21%, but keep in mind that the 3080 is considerably more expensive at $480 more than the 6750 XT. These games might be where AMD should focus their improvements, especially with older APIs that CSGO and GTA 5 use. At 1080p, the 6750 XT really shines. AMD markets it as an epic 1440p card, and it doesn't disappoint. It outperforms the 3060 Ti in more games at a GPU bound, and its driver improvements are on full display as it comes close to matching the much more expensive 3080 in some titles. When examining the 10 game average FPS for 1440p, the 6750 XT outperforms the 3060 Ti by 4%, and while the much more expensive 3080 does outperform by 28%, the 6750 XT still holds its own at 1440p. These are pretty impressive results so far, but will they hold up when we look at performance per dollar? We'll have to wait and see. When we compare the averages for 1080p and 1440p in 10 games, the 6750 XT edges out the 3060 Ti on average by 0.6%. This small difference between the cards might not be favorable in terms of value, which means it might not be the best value option. Remember, this card costs $55 more than the 3060 Ti. Additionally, the 3080 outperforms this card by 28%. But when we look at performance per dollar, it's clear that the 3060 Ti is a better value option, beating the 6750 XT by 19%. However, the 6750 XT does manage to edge out the 3080 by 40%, which is quite impressive. And when it comes to power consumption, it consumes less power than both the 3060 Ti and especially the 3080, 5% less than the 3060 Ti and a whopping 35% less than the 3080. So when we look at FPS per watt, or the effective efficiency of the cards, it's no surprise that it's the most efficient out of the lot, supplying 6% more FPS per watt than the 3060 Ti and 20% more than the 3080. In summary, while the 6750 XT may not be as strong in terms of value compared to the 3060, it still holds its own in terms of performance and efficiency. It outperforms the 3060 Ti in many GPU-bound games and consumes less power while doing so. It also manages to edge out the much more expensive 3080 in terms of performance per dollar and efficiency. The results for ray tracing were unexpected. In almost all games, the 6750 XT was left in the dust by the 3060 Ti and 3080. Even the 3060 outperformed it in some titles. Only in one game did it match the performance of the 3060 Ti, so it's no surprise that when we compare the 1080p ray tracing averages, the 6750 XT was beaten by the 3060 Ti by 19%, with the 3080 outpacing it by a staggering 65%. Not so great here, but again, no surprise. Ray tracing is Nvidia's forte, and until AMD can catch up, Nvidia will remain the king of ray tracing. At 1440p resolution, the 6750 XT graphics card struggles to keep up with its competitors in ray tracing. Despite improvements in drivers and hardware capabilities, it still falls short. When comparing the average performance in 1440p ray tracing, the 6750 XT is outperformed by the 3060 Ti in significantly outpaced by the 3080. Even the 3060 comes close to matching the performance of the 6750 XT, which is quite disappointing for those expecting more from this graphics card. When it comes to average FPS for both 1080p and 1440p with ray tracing, the results were as expected. On average, the 3060 Ti outperforms the 6750 XT, while the 3080 leaves it in the dust. In terms of value for ray tracing, the 3060 Ti once again comes out on top, while the 6750 XT surprisingly outpaces the 3080, albeit by a small margin. Power consumption is another factor to consider. The 6750 XT actually draws slightly more power than the 3060 Ti, while the 3080 consumes significantly more. This means that the 6750 XT delivers less performance than the 3060 Ti, while drawing more power. This is further supported by the performance per watt measurements, where the 3060 Ti outperforms the 6750 XT, and even the 3080 is more efficient. On average, the 3060 Ti outperforms the 6750 XT in FPS and value for ray tracing. The 6750 XT draws slightly more power than the 3060 Ti, but delivers less performance. The 3080 consumes significantly more power, but is more efficient in terms of performance per watt. When it comes to a more general comparison between these GPUs, the results are mixed. In 3D Mark TimeSpy 1080p, the 6750 XT actually outperforms the 3060 Ti. However, this win doesn't necessarily translate into real-world performance and rasterization, as we saw in our tests. The 3080 still outperforms it by a significant margin. In terms of generalized ray tracing performance in 3D Mark Port Royale, the 3060 Ti outpaces the 6750 XT, similar to what we saw in the ray tracing games we tested. The 3080 also leaves it far behind when it comes to the Puget Adobe Suite benchmarks. The 6750 XT falls short in Premiere Pro, is beaten by the 3060 Ti and outpaced by the 3080. The story is virtually the same in After Effects. One reason why AMD cards may fall short in performance in Premiere Pro and After Effects is due to their encoders being less effective than Nvidia's Nvidia encoders. This can result in lower performance when using these programs. So if you enter production and content creation, the 6750 XT might not be the best choice for you. When it comes to overclocking, we were able to push the core to 2860 MHz and boost the memory to 2304 MHz. Not bad for a refresh of the 6700 XT. What's even more impressive is the performance gains we saw. In Heaven benchmark at max settings at 1080p, the average FPS increased by 12%, with the 1.1% lows also receiving a nice bump in frames. The 0.1% lows saw a massive increase of 150%. This resulted in a much more consistent and smooth experience, outpacing and outperforming the overclocking results we saw with the 6650 XT. But what did this performance increase cost? Not much actually. Power consumption only increased by a mere 5%, while the card's temperature actually dropped slightly. The only downside was a slight increase in noise level, but it was barely noticeable. Overall, we were pleasantly surprised by the overclocking performance, especially given this is a clock in increase 6700 XT. It delivered an excellent increase in overall performance without significantly impacting power consumption, temperature, or noise levels. In conclusion, the 6750 XT is a GPU that has come a long way since its release. Priced higher than the 3060 Ti, it boasts impressive specs such as a higher base and Blues clock, a larger memory size, and lower power consumption. At 1080p, it holds its own against the 3060 Ti, but at 1440p, it truly shines as an epic gaming card. It outperforms the 3060 Ti in more games and isn't far behind the much more expensive 3080. While this ray tracing performance leaves something to be desired, it still delivers a satisfying gaming experience. The RX 6750 XT also excels in overclocking performance. In terms of value, the 3060 Ti still comes out on top, but the 6750 XT beats the 3080 in efficiency. With these impressive results, the 6750 XT is a top pick for gamers seeking high performance at 1440p. Anyways guys, that's all for today. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Also make sure to check out this video on the screen right now.